Well, as we heard earlier, a report by PwC and Diabetes New Zealand has predicted a quarter of all New Zealand's Pacific peoples will be diagnosed with type 2 diabetes in 20 years, if nothing is done about it now to change things. Now, the good news is there are some real solutions. Here to talk about them and his own experience with diabetes is CEO of the Fono, Tevita Funaki. Thank you for joining us on the show.
Thank you very much, Malama.
Now, you've had a look at the report. Were you surprised?
I was not surprised at all because we've seen the prevalence and the numbers around the diabetes. The great thing about this report is actually reminds both the government and those decision makers, our health sector, that we've got to do something about diabetes, about this prevalence and cost.
We've seen the focus that's been put on COVID, and obviously the government can, you know, leap to and make changes quickly. Do you want to see that kind of change happening for diabetes right now?
Yes, I think it needs the attention, it needs the resourcing, and it needs to, we've got to amend the policy that actually gave us a more equitable, more effective diabetes prevention and also management services.
And the cost to the country, I mean, $2.1 billion currently, but it's set to soar to $3.5 million. But also socially, like in terms of our families, I mean, everyone knows someone within our own family that has diabetes. What's the cost that you are seeing in terms of families in the community?
Oh, the burden of diabetes is actually real within families. The ones that actually, when you're diabetic, there's a whole lot of appointments that you got to go to. You see the doctors, you see the diabetic doctors, you see the eye specialist for this. So taking time off work, having somebody to take you, even if you are the main breadwinner in the family, the economic cost in there. And if you are a low income, it's actually much more. You know, the basic cost of rent and food and all that becomes a major challenge.
Now, what this report showed, that this could actually be changed. The stats that we're predicting, we say one in four of us specific people could be having diabetes in 20 years. It doesn't need to happen, but the solution doesn't have to cost the earth.
That's correct. And there are a number of things here. There's some activities that we need to focus on, and these are lifestyle changes and create an environment that actually supports easier choice and healthy choice.
And what do you mean by that?
What I mean is, like, you know, we've got to focus on the prevention around the pre-diabetes, and these are physical activities, get eating healthier. Those that actually are already diagnosed with diabetes, there are lifestyle changes that we could work on that will help omissions of diabetes. There are good, very good medication now, world-class, gold-standard medication that we got to ensure that. I'm glad that Pasifika now is funded. Pasifika need to access it.
And when they access it, you mean as well as not just being prescribed, but people understanding the medication and how to best take it.
Yeah. Our biggest challenge around Pasifika compliance is actually not cost and transport. It's actually understanding their condition, understanding of diabetes.
And it's a personal journey for yourself too, isn't it?
That's correct.
Had diabetes. Tell me about that.
But a couple of years ago, I was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, and I needed to actually change in terms of my lifestyle, and it was actually weight. I had to go through physical activities, process. I went through the bariatric and then to lose the weight.
Okay.
And I've reversed the diabetes and its impact on me and my family, even work.
Do you think that there should be more funding put towards the surgery? I mean, it's a drastic step, but do you think, I mean, the amount of money it can save as well is worth it, obviously?
Yes, the return on investment on bariatric in terms of when you look at the cost of diabetes, yes, it's at the other end of the spectrum, but I'm a champion of it now. So, like, we need to actually put more investment to it. However,
how much of it is, I remember Judith Collins saying it should be about personal responsibility. Mm-hmm. How much of the problem is that?
Well, the biggest problem, I mean, like, I've tried in terms of the activities to lose weight and all the diet that you got to go through. The bariatric is actually a tool that will give you the ability to lose the weight and give you the strength to be able to continue maintaining that lifestyle.
So, and I didn't mean to put you on the spot there. I struggled myself, and I know it's a big issue. And what would you want to say to the government at the end of the day?
We've got to put the microscope now and prioritise diabetes prevention and diabetes management. Policy has to change to be able to accommodate it. More services that are friendlier for Pacific. When we create an environment that is actually provides the support around healthier and choices, both food and also activities, then Pacific will thrive.
Then we will see change. Okay, then. Thank you very much for coming on the show. We really appreciate it.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you. Malo.